Good morning, Edgewood. Would you please stand for the pledge? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Do you believe in
magic? Good morning, guys. Welcome to EMTV. Today is November 26, 2024.
The last day before break. Reminder, we come back Tuesday, December 3rd.
Today for lunch, we have quesadilla, sour cream, refried beans, corn, assorted fruit, and applesauce.
Reminder, anyone who's planning to play and compete as part of the esports team needs to see Miss Wallace to get their paperwork started ASAP. Signups for tryouts for Fortnite, Overwatch, Valorant, Rocket League, Smash Bros. Ultimate, and chess will be outside Miss Walsh's room, and today is the last day, so go now. The 2025 yearbook is on sale for $65. You can order through yearbookforever.com or with an order form from the library or office. On December 2nd, there will be a Cyber Monday deal, and the coupon code is CyberSale25.
When we return from Thanksgiving break, end of course exam retakes will be given December 3rd through December 6th. If you need to retake an exam, you should have already received a letter in the mail. Make sure to eat a good breakfast and check in with your teachers for any missing work. NHS will be hosting a winter fair for the community on Thursday, December 5th from 4 to 7 p.m. If anyone is interested in volunteering, please see or email Miss Wallace. We'll have food, drinks, crafts, photo booths, and more.
Our Chicks Dig Us male volleyball tournament practices are December 2nd, 7 through 9 p.m., and December 3rd, 6 to 8 p.m. December 5th at 6:30 will be the tournament. Two junior boys teams will compete, then the seniors. The junior and senior winners will compete, and the winner of that game will play our championship volleyball team.
Also happening on December 5th is parent-teacher conferences in addition to the Winter Festival and the volleyball tournament. Lots of exciting things. The Kingsville Public Library is looking for volunteers to help at their annual winter celebration on Saturday, December 7th. Volunteers will help children and their caregivers navigate the event, help them with crafts, and assist library staff with setup and teardown. This is a great way to get service hours.
Spring musical tryouts are December 3rd and 4th. Anyone wishing to be involved must complete the forms. Contact Ms. Klein with questions.
This week is Thanksgiving. We decided to ask Edgewood students and their staff questions about the holiday, like their favorite foods and traditions.
Okay, Carmen, what are you most excited for your first Thanksgiving?
I think just eat with my family and make this tradition.
Yeah, the vibes?
Yeah.
Well, thank you. I hope you enjoy your first Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
What's your favorite Thanksgiving tradition?
I don't know, just saying, what you're thankful for.
Yeah, what are you thankful for?
My family.
Your family?
My mom.
Okay, is that it?
That's it.
Okay, thank you.
What is your favorite traditional Thanksgiving meal?
Thank you.
Mac and cheese.
Bye.
Mac and cheese.
Yes.
And what is your favorite traditional Thanksgiving meal?
I love mashed potatoes and gravy.
Thank you. What is your favorite traditional Thanksgiving meal?
Oh, probably turkey and corn.
Turkey and corn.
Okay, guys, what are we most thankful for this year?
My family and friends.
Family and friends. What are you most thankful for?
I'm thankful this is my 33rd year of teaching and my last.
Oh my God, he's retiring.
Ms. Henson, what are you most thankful for this Thanksgiving?
This Thanksgiving season. I think you guys already know. I'm thankful for my children and the joy they bring to my life. My upside down child. Because her brother shoved her over. They hate me.
I don't know why I read such things.
Because you're a square dad, an old deadhead.
Yeah, right, my boy.
Guys, come on, it's Thanksgiving.
I did not slave over a hot stove for your bickering.
Can I make the wish?
Go ahead, dear.
I wish for a dog.
If you tell your wish to everyone, it won't come true.
You don't know that.
Everyone knows that.
Just ignore your brother. Make your wish, sweetie.
I wish you would just leave me alone forever. My son!
I guess holiday wishes do come true.
How did Thanksgiving even start as a holiday? The history of Thanksgiving is something you probably don't know. Here's Logyn Candow with a story.
Thanksgiving is a national holiday that is celebrated by many Americans. And since Thanksgiving is coming up soon, let's dive into the past. In 1621, almost a year after arriving, the Plymouth and the Wampanoag shared an autumn harvest feast that is widely known as the first instance of Thanksgiving. But some historians believe that the actual first instance of Thanksgiving was in St. Augustine, Florida in 1565, roughly 60 years before Plymouth, with the native Timucuan celebrating the arrival of 800 Spanish settlers. Fast forward to 1863, when we were in the middle of a civil war, President Abraham Lincoln proclaimed that Thanksgiving be held the last Thursday in November. Thanks to a woman from Massachusetts named Sarah Josepha Hale, who spent almost 20 years petitioning Congress just to do so, the timing was perfect, as President Lincoln thought the holiday would help reestablish union, peace, and harmony following the war. I asked Mr. Bidwell and Mr. Hill to recount their stories on how Thanksgiving started. So Bidwell, what are your opinions on how Thanksgiving started?
Okay, Thanksgiving. I know there's a couple of different descriptions on how it actually became a thing. The most common one I hear as a history teacher is the story of the Pilgrims and how they had a very hard time when they first arrived in what we know as the United States. Some of that stemmed from like starvation. They couldn't get food, and then they had a really bad winter. And that led to Native Americans teaching them how to hunt and fish, which eventually led to a big dinner or feast where the Pilgrims ate with the Native Americans. That's the most common story. I also know that like the Puritan part of it related to religion. Puritans back in Europe would celebrate and be thankful for a successful harvest, and when they would have a great harvest, they would have a giant meal, and they'd be thankful for said meal, and that related to the religious part of it. And then I know it became an official day during the Civil War, because there was a woman, I cannot remember her name, but as history progressed and this was kind of like celebrated, it never fell on the same day. It could be a different day depending on what state you were in. So this woman was trying to make one day be recognized as Thanksgiving Day, where everyone would celebrate it at the same time. And Abe Lincoln is eventually the guy that's going to sign them into the last Thursday of November. But I wish I could remember that woman's name. I cannot. I think it was Sarah something. But those are the stories that I usually hear about when we discuss the origins of Thanksgiving.
So, Mr. Hill, what's your opinion on how Thanksgiving started?
Obviously, we know about the Pilgrims who came to America on the Mayflower back a long time ago. They struggled through the first winter, and then that first fall, they were thankful that they had survived for a year. So they and the people they met, the Native Americans, decided to have a feast. Many of those things that we eat at our traditional Thanksgiving dinner is not what they ate, because they only had what they had available at that time. But they were happy and bountiful for a year's of survival, and wanted to celebrate that, and it lasted not just one day, but a few days.
I hope everyone has a happy Thanksgiving this year. Now, back to the desk.
If you haven't met this year's foreign exchange student, Carmen, she has come to school in Ashtabula from Spain. Here she is with Blake Vegh with some information about her home country.
How you think Spain's looks like?
Like a sombrero.
Like an upside down sombrero. It's like you know the ones that you eat like salsa out of with the cheese?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
For
What's the most famous sport in Spain?
Famous sport? Let's go with soccer.
Yeah. Okay, say something in Spanish.
Hola, mi amigo, mi padre, mi amigo, y carita, seta, por Spanish.
So, what's the capital from Spain?
Most people will say Madrid.
Yeah.
See, there you go. I didn't know if I was 100% on that, but sometimes the bigger cities are not necessarily the capital all the time, but most people probably say Madrid.
Yeah, that's
Madrid.
All
right, good.
Name some Spanish food.
Some Spanish rice.
Yeah, what's the name?
Primo.
Rice?
I just always know it as Spanish rice.
That's
in my household.
That's called paella.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to say that. And I don't know if it's good in Spain or not, but we have here Spanish food is pasteles.
Oh, pasteles.
Yeah, those are really good too. So I know a little bit of Spanish from Spain and Puerto Rico, obviously a little different, but I know a little bit of food. Good stuff normally.
So name some Spanish food.
You know, off the top of my head, I'm just going to have to go with pasta. You know, I just think that makes perfect sense to me. Pasta. Mm-hmm.
And on November 28th, a happy birthday to Morgan Haywood. On November 29th, Bethany Wilker and Alec Weiser. November 30th, Gianna Iannetta and Liam Riley. December 1st, Blake Wasson and Aubrey Smith. December 2nd, Chloe Clancy and Devin Christine and German Rosa Morrow. Happy birthday. Starting this Tuesday, December 3rd, when we get back from break, NHS will be hosting a Christmas door decorating contest. The last day for the contest will be December 13th. The winning flex period will get freshly baked Papa John's pizza and ice cold soda.
And that is all. Have a great Thanksgiving break, Edgewood.
I guess Christmas miracles really do come true. It's Thanksgiving. It's holiday. It's holidays.
I look at the camera. Wait. Let me say it again. We're doing 3-2-1.
Wait, so Evie, first. My dog's name is like. My bad, got scared.
Go ahead, my dear.
I wish for a dog.
You tell everyone your wish, it won't come true.
You don't know that.
Everyone knows that.
Just ignore your brother and make your wish, sweetie.
I wish you would just be gone forever. Guys.
You tell everyone your wish ain't gonna come true. Oh, God.
I laughed a lot.